Before we get started, this type of work should be performed by a qualified individual or business only. If you're not sure what you're doing, working with your vehicle's electrical system can be dangerous both to you and your vehicle. If you have any doubts, don't hesitate to consult a professional. Welcome to another how-to video with the Dashcam Store. Today, we'll learn how to identify your vehicle's fuse type. Before we do any electrical work, ensure that your vehicle's engine is turned off and the key is completely removed from the ignition. You don't want to be a victim of a preventable accident. Now, there are at least four different types of fuses in modern vehicles, with the Mini being the most common. In order to utilize an installation kit or add a circuit fuse tab from the Dashcam Store, it's important to know which type of fuses are in your vehicle and where they're located. You have to verify the actual fuses, as there may be an extremely wide range of electrical system configurations present for each vehicle, year, make, and model. But how do you identify your fuses? The first step is locating your fuse box. Many vehicles have more than one fuse box, often located under the hood, in the trunk, or somewhere inside the cabin of the vehicle. For some vehicles, there may even be multiple fuse boxes in the cabin alone. To locate your fuse box, consult your owner's manual. Typically, the owner's manual can be found in the glove box, the trunk, or even with your spare tire. If you can't find or don't have a copy of your manual, a quick Google search for your vehicle's owner manual is almost guaranteed to turn up a PDF for you. Once you've got your manual in hand, check the index for fuses, fuse box, or even blown fuse replacement. The manual should direct you to an illustrated diagram of your vehicle showing the locations of all of your fuse boxes. Now, a quick disclaimer. If you see a picture of a fuse in the manual, you can't just assume this is necessarily the type of fuse that will be in your fuse box. Sometimes manufacturers use a generic image in the manual, which may or may not match what's actually in your vehicle. Anyways, referencing the owner's manual, locate the area which contains the fuse box. In most vehicles, the box is located behind an easily removable panel or cover. However, it could be behind the glove box, behind a kick panel in the driver or passenger side footwell, or under the carpet or the floorboard of some vehicles. To help you identify the fuse box, there may be a fuse or lightning bolt symbol on the cover. Once you find the fuse box, remove the cover to expose the fuses inside. Now that we've found our fuses, we're ready to pull one. But first, make note of the fuse or fuses you'll be removing. Now, some people like to draw a diagram, but taking a before photo on your phone works just as well. The key is knowing where to replace the fuse once you've pulled it and identified it. Carefully use a small set of pliers to remove one of the fuses from the fuse box. If you don't have pliers, many vehicles will include a small plastic tool called a fuse puller on the inside of the fuse box cover. As you might have guessed, it's designed to help you pull out the fuses. Now that you've got your fuse in hand, compare it against the chart and make note of the type of fuse your vehicle has. After you've identified your fuse, reinstall it to its original position and replace the fuse cover. And with that, you've learned how to identify your vehicle's fuses and where in your vehicle they're located.
Now recording.